The Philippine government moves to ease fuel prices by introducing higher ethanol blend in gasoline. But as Alvin El Chico tells us, this move is not sitting well with motorists and manufacturers. Take a look.
Car workshop owner Joshua Ang has some reservations about using gasoline with higher ethanol blend. Ang says the E20 or 20% ethanol blend on gasoline might be harmful to older made vehicles like his own car, which is a 1998 model. The government is set to launch soon the voluntary higher ethanol blend on gasoline, mainly to mitigate higher imported fuel prices.
Pagka sa year model, medyo iba-iba kasi. So kailangan mismo itanong sa bawat manufacturer kung ito ba yung sasakyan nila, eh, kaya tumakbo, ano yung pros and cons pag yan yung ikinarga, dahil mas may know-how sila dahil sila ang nagbuo nun yun sa technical.
The Chamber of Automotive Manufacturers supports government's move to encourage motorists to voluntarily switch to gasoline with higher ethanol blend. But it also warns old running vehicle models may be compromised by the higher ethanol blend. The Automobile Association of the Philippines said E20 is okay, but this may be more suited for vehicles used on a daily basis.
Kasi pagka hindi ka gumagamit araw-araw ng sasakyan at nai-imbak yung sasakyan mo sa garahe, nag-iipon ng tubig yan kasi ina-attract ng ethanol ang moisture. So pagka nangyari yon, corrosion at saka pagbabara ng fuel system mo mangyayari, so ayaw mo mangyari yon.
The group's president said ethanol as a chemical might have a negative effect on some car parts.
Nagkaklag ng fuel system yan at saka niluluto niya yung mga goma na gasket at saka mga plastic gas parts ng. Lalo na ngayon, ang daming plastic parts na ng makina natin.
An expert mechanic has also issued a warning to millions of motorcycle owners regarding future use of E20.
Magsisira yan ng pump at saka yung injector. Mas mabilis siyang masira. Aandar siya initially, pero sooner or later, magiging malakas ka sa fuel kasi lumalaki yung mga butas, napupudpud yung loob. Yung pump naman, nagsisis ka agad, nasisira siya kaagad.
Meanwhile, based on the first three trading days of the week, there is a possibility of a rollback in the price of diesel and kerosene next week. Oil prices eased following diplomatic efforts to prevent the spread of war in the Middle East. Other factors pulling down oil prices are higher U.S. oil inventory and weak economic data of some European states. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.
A local Tesla distributor asserts Filipinos can actually save more money by buying electric vehicles. EV Solutions says green vehicles are very economical despite their relatively high price. An interested buyer just needs to shell out at least 4 million pesos to purchase the cheapest EV model of Tesla. But the company maintains it is worth the price in the long run. EV Solutions also urging the government to ramp up efforts to make the Philippines more EV friendly.
Bottom line is very economical to the Filipino, meaning mas mura siya in the long run, wala siyang maintenance costs, wala siyang mga change oil, wala siyang spark plugs. Mm-hmm. Main issue talaga dito is a range issue. So people don't shift from ICE to EVs because of the range issue. Pero just last night, an executive from a very large electrical firm actually messaged us and reached out, and we wants to partner with us in installing charging stations in Metro Manila. The president himself has mentioned na gusto niya EVs yung mga kotse sa kalsada by 2040. So umaasa kami doon na with the government's help, national government and the local governments as well, they will put up electronic charging stations, not just in malls but in public locations.
9 secondary cities outside of Metro Manila will get financial assistance to boost public service delivery and grow their economies. Lady Vicentia talks about USAID's 624 million peso Urban Connect project in this report. Take a look.
The future is local. That is why the United States Agency for International Development, or USAID, is funding Philippine cities with potential to become economic drivers. Under the Urban Connect project, 9 secondary cities under the city's development initiative will be funded to be engines of economic growth, while also improving their public service delivery on health, education, and digitalization. The project will run for 5 years with 624 million pesos in funding.
It's about enhancing the quality of life for every Filipino. USAID will empower local governments and foster partnerships to achieve sustainability and resilience, ensure no one is left behind as these cities progress.
The 9 cities under the program are all outside of Metro Manila: Batangas, Legazpi, Puerto Princesa, Iloilo, Tacloban, Tagbilaran, Cagayan de Oro, General Santos, and Zamboanga. Since they have the potential to be hubs of innovation and opportunity, technical assistance will also be extended to these cities to encourage private investments, while also giving a space for small to medium enterprises to expand.
As urbanization accelerates, it brings both the promise of economic growth and challenge of ensuring that this growth is inclusive.
The national government and the private sector will work hand in hand in the project as it aims to boost local economies. More opportunities in secondary cities should also translate to the creation of jobs outside of Metro Manila.
A time where you don't have to leave your hometown to find success. The support from the USAID Urban Connect project brings this vision closer to reality.
In a span of 5 years, cities under Urban Connect are anticipated to have improved regulatory environment and advanced e-government solutions to attract more investments in their areas. Lady Vicencio, ABS-CBN News.
Mall operations in the metro will be adjusted ahead of the Christmas season in anticipation of heavy traffic. The Metro Manila Development Authority says starting November 13 to January 8, mall hours will be from 11 in the morning to 11 in the evening to avoid the rush hour. Mall-wide sales are also prohibited during weekdays unless owners submit a traffic management plan to MMDA. But stores or outlets inside the malls may still offer weekday sales as long as they do not publicly advertise them. Meanwhile, deliveries can only be made from 11 p.m. to 5 a.m. the next day, except for perishable goods such as food and ice. Now, aside from mall representatives, MMDA also met with DPWH representatives and public utility service providers. Now, earlier this week, the Metro Manila Council approved proposals to junk the window hours for the number coding scheme on many major roads, including EDSA, Commonwealth Avenue, Quezon Avenue, and Rojas Boulevard. But they haven't given the start date yet for the junking of the window hours. The Philippine Central Bank raised benchmark interest rates by 25 basis points to 6.5% in an off-cycle move on Thursday, saying it is ready to deliver follow-through policy action if necessary to tame inflation back to target. The move, which the governor telegraphed just days before, comes after the Monetary Board left rates unchanged in the last three policy meetings. BSP Governor Eli Remolona calls the catch-up move urgent.
I think we fell a little bit behind. That's the reason for this effort to catch up. About 92% of consumers think that in the next 12 months, inflation will be above 4%. It's similar for expectations by firms. That's very worrisome to us because, as you know, monetary policy cannot control supply-side price shocks, but it can serve to break the link between those supply-side shocks and expectations.
The central bank also raised its risk-adjusted inflation forecast for 2024 to 4.7% from a previous estimate of 4.3%. Transport costs, electricity rates, and wage adjustments are seen as primary upside risks. Inflation accelerated for second month in September to 6.1%. Meanwhile, Remolona also asserting the BSP's tightening, which is the most aggressive in two decades, has not really affected economic growth as feared by other government officials, including the country's chief economist, Arsenio Balisacan.
The Monetary Board is closely monitoring the impact of the increased interest rates as these work their way through the economy. The Monetary Board also continues to support fiscal efforts to sustain growth through more rapid program spending, as well as non-monetary interventions to address persistent supply-side pressures.